Hi children, in the previous class we learned about how to draw an angle and how to measure an angle using a protractor. And today we are going to learn a new topic, circle division. Okay? An angle of 1 degree is got by dividing a circle into 360 equal parts. Putting this the other way around, by drawing 1 degree angle at the center, we can divide a circle into 360 equal parts. So once again, an angle of 1 degree is got by dividing a circle into 360 equal parts. And by drawing 1 degree angle at the center, we can divide a circle into 360 equal parts. If we take two each of the angles together, we get 2 degree angles. Okay? If we take two each of the angles, we get 2 degree and 180 equal parts. And what if they take angles 3 at a time? If we take the angles 3 at a time, we get 120 equal parts. So to divide a circle into 30 equal parts, how many of the 360 parts should we take together? So listen, 360, and we can divide the circle into 30 equal parts. Okay, so 360 divided by 30, and we get 12 equal parts. Okay, understand? So in your geometry box there is two set square. Can you see this set square? So one is large, then other is small. So in the small set square, this is 90 and this is 45 degree and this angle is 45 degree. And the large set square, this is 60 degree and this is 90 and this 30 degree. Okay, so this is the angle of the two set square. And so we can divide a circle, we want to divide a circle using the corners of the set square. Okay, so first draw a circle. First draw a circle and take your small set square, and this is 90 degree. So using this corner we can divide the circle. So put this corner at the center of the circle and okay. So using the corner of the okay, so using the corner of the set square, you can divide the circle into four equal parts. Okay, four equal parts. Then how much is each angle? So we can divide 360 divided by the number of parts. Here the number of parts is 4. Then we get 90 degree. So this is 90 degree. So each of this angle is 90 degree. Then next we can draw this corner. Both of this angle of this corner is 45 degree. And so we want to divide a circle using the one corner. Okay, so first draw a circle. First draw another circle. Okay. Then this is the 45 degree. Then using this corner, we can divide the circle. Okay. So this is the center. And put this corner क्या? Okay. So using the this corner of the set square, we can divide a circle into 8 equal parts. Okay, 8 equal parts. Then how much is each this angle? How much is this angle? So 360 divided by number of parts is here 8. See, we get 45 degrees. So each this part is each this angle is 45 degree. Then next, using this set square, we can also divide a circle into many parts. Okay. Then next, this is the large set square. And using this set square, we can divide the circle. Okay. And take the corner, take this corner. So using this corner, put this corner in the center of the circle. Using this corner, we divide a circle into 6 equal parts. Then how much is this angles? So 360 divided by, here the number of parts is 6. See, we get 60 degree. Okay, so like this you can also draw this corner, and using this corner you can divide a circle. Okay. We want to divide a circle into 5 equal parts. So how can we divide a circle into 5 equal parts? How can we divide a circle into 5 equal parts? So before dividing a circle into 5 equal parts, we want to find how much is each angle. Okay, so we want to divide a circle into, we want to divide this circle into 5 equal parts. Okay, so take, so divide 360 by 360 divided by 5. So we get the 72 degree. Okay. So in this circle, we want to divide 5 equal parts. We want to divide this circle into 5 equal parts. So we get the angle is, each angle is 72 degree. So using the protractor, we can divide the circle into 5 equal parts. Place your protractor at the center. So this is center, and take 72 degree. Okay. The next, so like this you can draw, so you can divide a circle into 5 equal parts. Okay, so when we join this points, we can get a figure like this. Okay, so this figure is called regular pentagon. Regular pentagon. So like this, you can draw figures of 6, 8, 9, 10, 12 sides inside a circle. Okay. So this portion is over. The next, the last portion is angles in a clock. Angles in a clock. The hands of a clock make different angles at a different time. The hour hands rotate through 360 degree in 12 hour. So it rotates through 360 divided by 12, 30 degree. Okay, 30 degree in an hour. In an hour. See, what is the angle at 2 o'clock? So what is the angle at 2 o'clock? So the angle at 2 o'clock is 60 degree. What is the angle at 4 o'clock? So this is 30 degree and this is 60 degree and this is 90 degree, and this is the angle at 4 o'clock is 120 degree. Okay. So what is the angle at 3 o'clock? What is the angle at 3 o'clock? 90 degree. Okay. The hour hand rotate through 360 degree in 12 hour. Okay. So 30 degree in 1 hour. Okay. So the angle at 1 o'clock is 30 degree, 2 o'clock is 16 degree, and 3 o'clock is 90 degree, and then 4 o'clock is 120 degree. So this is our the last section of this chapter. So in this chapter we learn how to draw an angle and how to measure an angle using the protractor. Then the third section is how to divide a circle into equal parts using the set square or using the protractor. And the last section is angles in a clock. Okay. The hour hand rotate through 360 degree in 12 hour. So it rotates through 30 degree in an hour. Okay. So this is the these are the topics in the first chapter. So I think all of you understand. Thank you.